right, I've had one heck of a time with these lamps. First of all, I was wondering, I had never heard of 1158 bulbs before, and if I had, I forgot about them, but they're like 1157s, but they're for, they're dual filament, but they're for 6 volt. So you try and hook these up to 12 volt, they just burn out. And of course, I'm going to be running 12 volt. What I found out was, oh, and then my other problem was that all this hardware that comes out of the sockets was just all rusty and falling apart and stuff and pretty much useless, you know. So I found out that you can buy the replacement for that for about under $3. It's made by Grote, G-R-O-T-E, G-R-O-T-E, and let's see, basically they call this, it's a harness, it's a pigtail is what it is. It's a socket pigtail, a dual pin taillight socket pigtail, and the item number here from Grote is 68130. So you can ask for that or order it in your auto parts store. Get a couple of these, and this just basically slips right through there. I've already shined it all up. I took my wire brush. Remember this? Fits in there just like that, and turn it for a while. You know, to clean the inside. Kind of brushed up the outside and cleaned it up also. And basically that just slips right in there like that. Let me slip it in there. There, I slipped it in there. You have to be able to see. Now this has a tit. This round top here, this right here has a tit right there, and that's a guide. That goes in this slot here. Alright, that lines up the two pins there for the way the light will line up when you screw it in. You want everything to match up, so that's what that's for. So you tilt it in pin first, see? Tilt it in there like that. See there? I'm pushing on it so that you don't hurt it, so you don't take it off. As it's tilted, get it lined up in that slot. If I can find it now. Yeah, you just get it lined up in that slot, and then you can pull the wires and it moves. See, it moves down. Okay. Then, here's the secret to going over to 12 volts, because we're still at the same place. We have that 1158 bulb. And the problem with 1157 is the two pins, there's a pin on each side for that go in there and the thing twists and locks, are level with each other, you see, on the 1158 bulb. That's the way this socket is. 1157, these two pins are offset from each other. One's high and one's low. So what do you do? Well, there just happens to be an 1176, which was made for some couple of years for Toyota, and it matches the 1158, except it's for 12 volts. So the pins, as you can see, are on at the same level. Everything lines up perfect. It's the same size. It's dual filament. And guess what, folks? It just slips right in there just as easy as pie. It's a strong spring. It's a brand new spring. Twist it, and it's in there. Now, the only other thing I did was, because these are old cans, I cleaned them up the best, but you know, that doesn't really shine. I want a lot of reflection, so I took some foil. Put that in there. I made a piece like this, see? I just made it by using the other side for a form. That way it squished in here, and I cut out a notch like that for this other unused lamp now. We're not going to use that. And the reason we're not using those is because I used those for an extra lamp for stopping light because it was 6 volts and everything was dim. So now with the 12 volts, we don't have to worry about that. So this just kind of slips under here, under that bulb. It's sort of like that. Well, I did it without the bulb in it before. Okay. So I already had this in here. I took it out to show you. There. She was never taken out. It fit perfect the first time. There we go. Anyway, that's enough covered for reflection. The bulb will hold it all in there. It's a strong spring. There you go. So, there we go. I should be able to hook those up and they should work just fine. You want to make sure that you cleaned those sockets good enough to get a good ground, so right now is a good time to test. Do it with our multimeter, our VOM. Just test from the outside casing of the light to any part of the lamp frame here. You do, you got it. So, same over here. Yep, we got it. So our ground is good. If you want to check the pins too, just check between either one of the hot wires to ground. Remember, that's a filament, it's a dead short. See, it works. Check the other one. Works. This isn't enough voltage to light up the bulb, but basically that's what we've done, is supplied power all the way through the bulb to the other. So we have continuity all the way through the light bulb. So this will all work when we install it. We have the original lamps, and it cost me about, I think about $10 for the two bulbs and the two sets of pigtails, the two pin pigtails. Alright, so before we install these in the trailer, the last thing I had to do was figure out how to keep the water out of it, because as you can see, with just the lens on there and the ring, the beauty ring that holds it, you hear that? It's going to leak water, and that's what I found when before I cleaned these. I found a line where the water was in here, so we don't want water getting there. So I went down to my favorite Ace Hardware store, where they have every kind of washer known to man there, and was hoping I would get lucky, and I did. And what I found was, this is a washer for your garbage disposal or your sink drain. It's a rubber washer. It's about a little less than 1/8 of an inch thick. It just happens to be 4 inches, and it's just a hair bigger than the lens, but guess what, that's okay. You set that on there. I tried this before I left and bought it and left, and you put the beauty ring on it and it holds down nice and tight. It's just big enough to where it's everything's snug, everything's really snug, and it's nice and tight. You put the screws in there and tighten that down, and there's not going to be any water gets in there. You don't hear any rattling. So that finishes off my tail lamps as far as functionality is concerned. Later on, when we get into polishing, more polishing, I'm going to take these beauty rings off and I'll polish them. And then they'll go back on. But see, I want to get everything sealed up on the outside. I'm not doing anything with polishing or painting. Except as I take things off and polish them and put them back on. So I want to get it sealed up first. So there you go. There's everything you wanted to know about vintage flush-fitting tail lights. Just about all these electrical things that you learned here can be utilized on just about any tail lamps, the wedding cake style with a backing plate or whatever. You just got to know that you want to seal everything so no water gets in anywhere. That's important.